Charles Darwin. I'm sure that when I say this name, you are more than familiar with it. Proposing the theory of evolution via natural selection was a controversial suggestion during his time. However, this would become arguably the most prolific discovery to the scientific community to date. Natural selection is the process where organisms more suitably adapted to their environment are more likely to survive and reproduce, driving the process of evolution. One of the key players in providing insights into natural selection and adaptive radiation were Darwin's finches. These finches occupy the Galapagos Islands and belong to the subfamily Geospizinae, which are renowned for their varying bill size and shape. While they are technically termed Darwin's finches, this name is not suggestive of their history. Darwin was not particularly interested in the finches in the Galapagos and was more invested in the mockingbirds on the island. Nonetheless, the term Darwin's finches was popularised by David Lack, who published a book named Darwin's Finches in 1947, analysing a collection of the birds. Regardless, the name stuck, along with their scientific significance. For many years to come, a series of scientists researched Darwin's finches. One of the more significant were Peter and Rosemary Grant, who spent 40 years studying the finches on Daphne Major Island. The first years were relatively uneventful, and the island flourished along with the finch population. However, in 1977, drought hit the island. At this time, Peter Boag was also studying Darwin's finches with Peter Grant. They witnessed a dramatic change in the environment on Daphne Major Island, including that the seed abundance was massively reduced. The seeds also became larger and harder on average, which was a key selective agent in driving the natural selection of Darwin's finches. Let me explain. A selective agent is the environmental factor which acts on a population to drive natural selection, which in this case were the seeds. In fact, only one of 388 finches banded in 1976 survived past 1978 after the drought, demonstrating to Boag and Grant the extreme selection intensities that were at play here. So, what happened? Why was there such a large reduction in population size due to natural selection? The large and hard seeds that now predominated on Daphne Major could only be cracked by large birds with deep bills. Therefore, these birds were more likely to get food, survive, and reproduce as they were most able to feed on the limited seeds. This is what drives natural selection. Organisms that have a characteristic that allows them to exploit an environmental niche will be able to better survive and reproduce. The findings from Grant and Boag's research can also be described on a molecular level by the finch's genotype. An organism's genotype is their genetic material, or DNA, which contains segments of genes. As a result of an organism's genotype, they will express a particular phenotype, or physical characteristic. Therefore, in the finch population described during the drought, the gene encoding for long bills increased, while the gene encoding for short bills decreased towards extinction from the population. Genes are selected based upon their success, so the long bill gene was selected for, while the short bill gene was selected against. Grant and Boag also described that directional natural selection was acting on the finch population. Directional selection occurs when the fitness of an organism to its environment is increased as the value of a particular trait is increased. Since the relative fitness of the finch increases as the size of the bill increases, Boag and Grant were able to demonstrate directional selection occurring in the finch population. In fact, the selection intensities calculated by Boag and Grant were exceptionally strong. I won't go into the mathematics of this, however, these selection intensities were the highest yet recorded for a vertebrate population. This was an incredible achievement and shows that the famed Darwin's finches continued to be of great significance to the scientific community, long after the time of Charles Darwin.